What is up, East Mountain High? It's your student body president, Alina Carter, coming at you with wired headphones because AirPods ain't in the budget. This is Student Council's very first attempt at doing a virtual assembly. Hopefully, it'll also be our last because we'd love to see you guys in person this fall of 2020 for the new school year. As of right now, for this virtual assembly, we're going to kick it off with your principal, Mr. Smith.
I gonna have myself a real good time. I feel alive. I am the world turning inside out. Yeah, the floating around in ecstasy. Oh, so
don't stop me now.
Living through the sky like a tiger, defying the laws of the gravity. And the risk car passing by like Lady Godiva. I'm gonna go, 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 go to stop me and me.
We are the leaders of the pack.
The sky, yeah. One of the crazy loves of all of Mr.
Next, we had some teachers send in some videos of some words of encouragement just to share a little piece of their hearts with all the students of East Mountain High. So I hope that you watch these and that you get something encouraging out of them.
Hi, guys. I just wanted to pop in and tell you that I miss you and to hang in there, that we're going to get past this and we'll be three-dimensional again instead of floating heads in boxes, though it is rather enjoyable to do the Brady Bunch, though most of you don't know what that means, but that's okay. It's fun for me. Live in the moment. Try not to worry about all the craziness that's going on right now. Go hug a tree. I even saw something that's on Facebook, so you know it's true, that people are being encouraged to hug trees. So go hug a tree, be careful of sap, and that's all the advice I have for you right now. I love you, and we'll see you again soon.
I don't have anybody to throw it to.
Seniors, I made an acrostic poem for you today. Class of 2020, you are resilient, ready to take on the world. Example to all, show us what you're made of. Incredibly courageous, love to live and live to love. Inspirational, exceptional, naturally curious and truly remarkable. Love, Mrs. Millay.
Good morning, East Mountain High School. I have been asked by your venerable student council president to give you some words of encouragement, some thoughts for getting you through the day and through the weeks to come, and thought I might offer a couple of things. First thing, remember the power of framing effects. If you've been in my class or you've been in my world before, you know that this is something I really like to harp on. There are the facts of a situation. A lot of what you're going to be experiencing is likely unpleasant. Some of you are going to be facing some really challenging times ahead. I hope that you and your loved ones are staying safe. I hope that no one is experiencing profound economic hardship, but it's likely that some of us will. As you go through these difficult times, whatever they may be, it's really powerful to remember that you have very little control over what happens out here in the world, but you have a lot of control over the story that you tell yourself about this. Is this going to be a moment where you wallow in the difficulty and simply crumple under the pressure? Or do you rise to the occasion? Do you take this as an opportunity to grow, to change, to build yourself into a more resilient or interesting or responsible individual? There's a real power in framing adversity in a way that makes it a growth experience rather than expecting that growth to just kind of happen downstream after the fact. If you can embrace that mindset while the challenging stuff is happening, it can be really transformative for your experience. So that's thought one. Thought two is a little bit different, but related. I think the entire coronavirus epidemic has highlighted the fact that the generations that have come before you, those folks who are older and supposedly wiser, are not always older and wiser than you. That we possess sort of blind spots. There are going to be foibles in our judgment. And we need your voices in the room. We need your generation's leadership. You guys are set to inherit a world that has a lot of challenges on the horizon. And the sooner you can come to the forefront and lend your voice and provide your leadership, the better off we will all be. So look for those small opportunities. They're probably not very apparent right now, but keep an eye out for them. Those opportunities to hone your leadership, to hone your strengths. And when we come out of this and make it to the other side, lean in, participate in your communities, find those opportunities and step up to the plate. You all have a lot to offer. I miss you all a great deal. I wish that I could be offering this advice in person instead of virtually, but here we are, making the most of this. I hope you're all staying safe and weathering this moment as well as you can. You're in my thoughts. Peace and love.
Miss Wood, Miss Millay, Mr. Scheubach, Mr. Wood, and Miss Cuny, we all appreciate those words of encouragement, and we love you just as much, and we hope that you guys are doing well. Seniors, this next segment is for you. Some of the students in the recording arts class wrote a song about what it is to be a senior. It's super relatable, super funny, and so we hope you guys enjoy this.
Yep. How are you doing, Katie?
I'm stressed. Just like every other high school senior, I'm a mess. But I guess it's okay to be stressed. All I need is I'm out here trying to do my best.
I'm really trying.
Like all the rest. Flashing back to freshman year, I can't believe that I'm already here.
Oh dear.
Wondering which way I will turn, trying hard to find my own way.
Right.
Harder than they say. Cause we've got college applications and senior appreciations. And everything is piling on my plate.
You can't eat it.
stressed. Just like every other high school senior, I'm a mess. But I guess it's okay to be stressed. All it means is I'm out here trying to do my best, like all the rest. Flashing back to freshman year, I can't believe that I'm already here.
Oh dear.
Wondering which way I will turn, trying hard to find my own way.
Left or right? It's so much harder than they say.
I'm always tired.
Honestly, I'm kind of ready to be done.
But I mean, it was kind of fun.
Oh.
Thanks, Recording Arts, for that awesome song that you wrote for the seniors. Seniors, I hope you all enjoyed that. Hope you had a good laugh. For this next segment, Student Council just wanted to personally thank each and every one of you teachers, staff, faculty, the board. We just wanted to thank you guys for the way you've been adapting, the way that you've been all of these Mountain High's rock and foundation, educationally and mentally. Thank you guys for your support. We understand that you guys are also just as emotionally drained as we are, but we're just so thankful that you are there, that you're helping us finish out this year strong. And so Student Council wanted to personally thank you guys. So here's this.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for all your hard work.
Thank you guys for everything you do.
Thank you so much for everything you're doing. I really appreciate you making so much of an effort for our learning.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for staying positive in these tough times.
Thank you so much for being so supportive and understanding.
Thank you for working extra hard and supporting all of your students.
Thank you for staying positive.
Thank you for everything you do.
Thank you.
Thank you, teachers, for always dedicating so much time to your students.
Thank you for all of your support. It is never unnoticed.
Thank you, teachers, for teaching us through these difficult and hard times. We all appreciate you.
Thank you for being so reasonable and understanding when it comes to our assignments.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you to the teachers at East Mountain. Over the last 4 years, you have taught me so much, not just in the classroom, but life lessons. And in this difficult season, you have shown me what it means to be people who are caring, understanding, and innovative. I know that this hasn't been easy, but just know that I miss you and look forward to when I can see you not just behind a Google Classroom screen. Thank you for all of the work and love that you put into our school. We love and miss you. T-Wolves.
All right, East Mountain High. Well, in conclusion, I would like to say a couple things as student body president. First, I'd like to shout out Mr. Smith. Mr. Smith, even though this first year has been a little wacky for all of us, you've done an incredible job being our principal. I'm just so thankful that you're in this position of leadership. I've seen so much success and flourishing already, and that's all because of you and because of the staff and the teachers. So to you, to the teachers, to the staff, I want to thank you guys so much for the hard work you're putting into our school. You guys don't go unnoticed. We appreciate you. We love you. Some of us rely on you for relationships and emotional connection, and the fact that you guys provide that for us, we're forever grateful. We're forever thankful, and you guys are going to have special places in our hearts for a really, really long time. So I just want to thank you, Mr. Smith, as our principal. I can't wait to see the kind of success you put East Mountain on. For the teachers, I want to thank you guys again for just being strong. Know that we understand you are human too, that your feelings matter. I hope and pray that you and your families are staying safe and that you guys are staying healthy. And I hope that you guys are staying encouraged yourselves. Thank you so much for encouraging us. But I want to encourage you and to let you know that we support you. We hope you're doing well. We hope you're staying healthy. I also just want to give a shout out to all the students. Guys, this is crazy. These are crazy times. obviously none of us expected this to happen. We're living through history. This is going to be something that's going to be in the textbooks years from now. And I just want to let you guys know that this is going to pass to the seniors. Guys, high school is only a small part of our lives. And even though it could be a great one, it's not even the beginning. I told this to student council, you got to have a little rain before the rainbow comes. And this new chapter is the beginning of the rest of our lives. It is not the end. So I encourage you guys to understand that, to realize that from now on, you're going to have successes, you're going to have failures, but either way, you need to keep pushing, you need to keep staying positive, and you need to keep growing as people and as you enter young adulthood. So seniors, I just encourage you guys. Juniors, sophomores, and freshmen, I encourage you guys as well to stay positive. You're going to come back into this fall stronger than ever, more educated than ever, more supportive of each other than ever. I hope that you keep our East Mountain community close. I hope that you keep the spirit going, because our school is special. It is not like other schools. And even though we're small, we have one of the biggest hearts out there, and we have one of the biggest hearts in the state. I truly believe that. With that being said, I'm going to go ahead and conclude this virtual assembly. I love all of you guys. I love each and every one of you and care about you. I've been so honored to serve all of you as the student body president, and I can't wait to see what kind of things are going to come to the table in these next couple years. Go T-Wolves!